I couldn't. Here's the thing. We're talking about this. I couldn't care less about Kanye himself, whether people like him or not. He's not a savior. He's not a modern philosopher, as they said on Fox and Friends. For me, it's all about, A, the truth and the reaction from the left. They're asking him to apologize, not for anything racist, not for anything. They're asking him to apologize for supporting Donald Trump. Aren't we vindicated now? Because we said, don't apologize. It's not about the racism. It's not about the sexism. It's just about anything that you disagree with.
Yep. Yeah, well, Crowder, I got to tell you, I'm more of a Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin guy than I am, say, Kanye West guy.
I would have guessed Cher, but those work too.
Oh, you love those stereotypical jokes.
I do. I have never met a lesbian who did not like Melissa Etheridge. I know you don't run in the same circles, but here's, I will say, in my life, I've never met one. They all, every time it's like I walk up, I'm like, hi, I'm Steven. I'll come to my window. You're like, stop it.
What was happening at the window? Did she have a pie? I mean, what was, oh, there's a joke.
There,
all right.
No, I don't think we're a pie.
So I agree with you. Look, I don't know a ton about Kanye beyond the cultural relevance of Kanye and the George Bush thing during Katrina and some of that stuff. I'm not a huge, it's just not my kind of music per se, but some of it's pretty good. David had me playing the one that he did with Daft Punk is pretty cool. Okay, whatever.
Yeah.
But I actually do think he is a modern day philosopher in that this is someone that, yes, he may not be the greatest philosopher of all time, but he can truly move minds with his words. And for all of us, for whatever little political differences we have, for all of us that for these last couple of years have been banging and banging and banging against this political correct nonsense, this lunacy from the left, this cultural Marxism and collectivism and all that, this is what we needed. Now, we shouldn't be worshiping the guy.
Sure.
I have no idea what his politics are, but he just gave a ton of oxygen to the space that we've been operating in, and we needed oxygen there. So I truly think this thing is massive. Mm-hmm. But yes, we cannot treat him like some sort of political hero or some, you know, anything like that.
Yeah. Oh, I'm
hearing a lot of we. This doesn't sound like a classical liberal Democrat thing. A lot of we's.
Yeah, a lot of we. I don't know what he's talking about.
You want freedom? I'm in with you.
There you go. Okay, there you go. We. So we're collectivists as it relates to individualism. Hmm. We're the collective individualists. No, but I understand exactly where you come from. I'm actually a big Kanye West fan. We used to use the last bump before we did the drowning dance, which we'll do here shortly, was the and it's out to the fans to see if they can remember it. Was a Kanye West song every single episode before we went to YouTube, because then it was a copyright issue and we had to actually get clearance from Pogo and I think Andrew WK and a few artists. So I've always been a Kanye fan, actually. I've always said he's a dumbass, but he's a brilliant MC, and my opinion has not changed at all. I think he's a dumbass, but I think there are a lot of dumbass liberals and a lot of dumbass conservatives, and I think that, you know what, it's a lot more brave. We just talked about this, for him to come out and say what he said than slap on a pair of fake rubber tits and get on the cover of Vanity Fair. So good on him for going against the grain.
Of course. And, you know, the irony here is that this isn't that you have to be a Trump supporter because you like Kanye or something like that. The point is that the intellectual hostage taking that we all know about, that we've been screaming about, this lunacy that has infected colleges, that has infected the media, that has affected the political establishment, that Trump kind of, you know, beat on for these last couple of years. Kanye just opened the door. He opened the door for you to say, you know what? I'm a little different. And maybe that isn't because guys like us are the biggest fan of him, but he speaks to another segment of the population that needed to hear it. And I think that these people on the left, they're followers. And the second they see that it's okay to think a little bit differently, they're going to break in huge numbers.
Yeah, and he might have just opened the door because he has an axe to grind over Barack Obama calling him a jackass. It could have been as simple and narcissistic as half of Donald Trump's tweets, but if it allows other people...
He really is the brother of Trump, because Trump is the same thing. I think White House correspondence in there has really set Trump off the presidency, because he's so pissed.
I think you're exactly right. So I'm curious to see what the fallout is from this.